Dear students, now we will be discussing about learners with cerebral palsy. So, what is cerebral palsy? So, cerebral palsy is a group of permanent movement disorders that appear in early childhood. It is a persistent but not unchanging disorder of movement and posture due to a defect or lesion of a developing brain. So cerebral means of the brain, palsy means lack of muscle control. It occurs in about 2 in 1000 live births. It may be the most common pediatric problem. So what are the different signs and symptoms includes? First is poor coordination. Second is stiff muscles. Third is weak muscles. Fourth is tremors. Fifth includes problem with sensation, vision, hearing, swallowing, and speaking. Often babies with cerebral palsy do not roll over, sit, crawl, or walk as early as other children of their age. Difficulty with the ability to think or reason and seizures each occurs in about 1/3 of people with cerebral palsy. While the symptoms may get more noticeable over the first few years of life, the underlying problems do not worsen over time. Now coming to the learning characteristics of learners with cerebral palsy. So they have learning disabilities, visual impairments, hearing problems, speech problems, drooling issues, and behavioral problems. Need braces, crutches, or a wheelchair to get around. They need help moving around in class or reaching things. They need assistive devices for writing and speaking. They have difficulty sitting still in classroom and have uncontrolled movements. Students with cerebral palsy have difficulty with bladder and bowel control, and many need to use a bathroom frequently. Students with cerebral palsy have seizures and need occupational therapy, physical therapy, and speech therapy during the school day. Assessment of learners with cerebral palsy. When assessing children with cerebral palsy, their character can be an important factor. Children with cerebral palsy may not be able to walk, talk, eat, or play in the same ways as most of other kids. But with the proper diagnosis by a team of healthcare professionals, they can be helped to lead a life without complete family dependence on other members of the family. When assessing children with cerebral palsy, many factors must be taken into consideration. With cerebral palsy covering such a varying spectrum of conditions and degrees of severity, each case is as unique as the individual affected. Assessing children with cerebral palsy can sometimes be difficult. Some people with cerebral palsy have trouble controlling their movement and facial expressions, but their mental abilities are not impaired. Some have higher than average intelligence, while others have moderate or severe learning disabilities. Most diagnosed with cerebral palsy are of average intelligence, just like those without cerebral palsy. While there is no cure for cerebral palsy, assessing children with cerebral palsy can provide correct treatment from the early stages of diagnosis and ease the effects of cerebral palsy. So the possible physical problems can be seen in cerebral palsy are unable to lift head when lying or held in sitting position, unable to move to change position, unable to use hands for support or movement or for function, unable to function, protect or reach out with arms while sitting independently, unable to get in and out of sitting position, unable to lean forward or backwards while sitting independently, poor balance reactions in standing, that is unable to protect effectively when falling, unable to transfer weight forward, backward or sideways in standing position, unable to get into or get out of standing position. So that's all in this particular video. Thank you very much.